Hi, I'm Matt, the in-house existential crisisologist here at Red Pepper, and welcome to another edition of Touch on Tech, where we get smart on the latest technologies and how they work so we can share it with you.
Reality is a lie.
Snap recently released their latest spectacles, which are a pair of augmented reality glasses that are quite stylish. They give you a glimpse into the future of what augmented reality will be, where instead of holding up your phone to look around and see 3D objects attached to the real world, it'll actually be on your eyeballs. So it'll look like it really is part of the real world. There'll be no separation between you and digital objects everywhere. You can transform your entire environment digitally. And with the new advances in AR kit from Apple, you can scan an entire room and then overlay anything you want into that room. So if you're wondering where you're gonna display all those NFT artworks that you picked up a few months ago, guess what? You can see them now in AR. You can decorate your whole house with NFTs if you want, but only you can probably see them. Come visit my cool white box house. So the future of AR opens up an entire world of possibilities of things we couldn't do before. Like you can turn a human into a musical instrument. Lucas Risotto has done that with some HoloLenses, which are some augmented reality glasses from Microsoft. And he has made a musical instrument that shows up in AR that he controls with his hands. And he attached it to his girlfriend and used her to play a musical instrument. So being able to attach digital content to physical things opens up a whole world of possibilities. If you have a dog running around, you can attach a digital post-it note to it. So when you get home later and you see your dog walk by, it's got all your post-it notes on it. Oh, thanks for reminding me. Google has released a new AI that can generate its own AI chips. So it's an AI that's building chips faster and better than humans can build them. And the interesting part is, they built them in a way that humans didn't think they should be built. Humans like to build their chips like little tiny cities. You've seen those chips before, but the AI has decided to do it a little bit different. They made more organic shapes in ways that the researchers thought weren't possible. And the researchers looked at these chips and thought, we're not gonna make those. And the AI said, you probably wanna make those. And when they did, the researchers found out that they performed just as well and better than the chips they had been building themselves. So basically what happened was we generated some AIs that generated chips, and then they told us the chips we're building are not good ways to build chips. So in summary, computers built a computer that told us we're building computers wrong. Whew! Gosh, that bunker is intense. Actually, it's not. It's inside our office. If it were intense, it'd be at Bonnaroo. Now that we're back, let's talk a little bit more about AIs and how AI is giving people eyes that move around. It's actually bringing photos to life. You just upload a still photo to myheritage.com and then it'll turn it into an animated 3D face. It looks real. It blinks. It moves its mouth. It even tries to smile. So you could take this a step further and add OpenAI's GPT-3 text generator and actually have a conversation with the photo. Just like in Harry Potter, you can talk to paintings. So GANs are a particular type of neural network that can generate imagery. You just train it on a bunch of photos of something you like, and then it'll generate new ones that the world has never seen before. It could even start to generate things like movie posters. And with a simple text description, like a movie poster for a new cool movie, it can take that text and generate an image that represents a cool new movie poster. And it's something that has never been seen before by the likes of human eyeballs. Well, that's it for another edition of Touch on Tech. Thanks for stopping by and spending some time with us. And we hope to see you next time on another edition of Touch on Tech. Bye.